Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle, and here is 30 degrees, and here is 24 degrees, and then these two sides are equal, and alpha is asked. Okay. First of all, we know that in a triangle, sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees, right? So here, this angle, let's calculate here, 180 minus 30 plus 24, right? Okay. That means angle BAC equal 126 degrees. That means angle BAC is an obtuse angle, right? Let's remind you, if you have an obtuse triangle, let's draw here. Let's call here alpha. Alpha is larger than 90 degrees. So alpha is an obtuse angle. That means if we draw circumcircle of this triangle, center of circumcircle of this triangle must be outside of this triangle. Let's call here center point. And then if we connect this center point with corner of this triangle, this three blue line must be equal, right? Because these are radius of circumcircle. Okay. And then let's call here theta. Here, this angle must be equal to theta, right? Because of center angle. And then let's call here beta. Here must be equal to beta, right? Okay, let's go to the question. Let's call here O. We know that O is the center of circumcircle of this triangle. And then let's connect center point with corner of this triangle. This three blue line must be equal, right? Because of radius. And then let's draw the circumcircle of this triangle like this. And then notice that if here is 30 degrees, here must be equal 60 degrees, right? Because of center angle. Therefore, we know that these two sides are equal. And notice that angle AOC equals 60 degrees. That means AOC triangle is an equilateral triangle. So here is 36 degrees. And here, this angle must be equal 60 degrees. Okay. Let's write here. AOC triangle is an equilateral triangle. So these two sides must be equal to others. Right? Okay. And then notice that if here is 24 degrees, here this angle must be equal 48 degrees, right? Because of center angle. And then this side must be equal to others because of radius. Notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Isosceles triangle. Therefore, BO must be equal AO. And then the base angles equals 180 minus 48 over 2. That means base angles equal 66 degrees, right? So 36 degrees left here. Okay. Next step. If we connect O and D point like this, notice that OBD triangle is also an isosceles triangle, right? That means BO must be equal BD. And then if you calculate the base angles here, must be equal 72 degrees and 24 degrees left here, right? So this angle must be equal to 36 degrees. And then notice that this triangle is an equilateral triangle, and these two angles are equal, and these two angle is also equal. That means, let's remind you, if we have an isosceles or equilateral triangle, it doesn't matter. And let's draw here, and let's connect with corner, and then let's call here alpha. This angle must be equal alpha, right? And then you know that if here is theta, here this angle must be equal theta. Why? Because this triangle is an equilateral triangle, but it wouldn't change if it was isosceles too. Okay, that means here must be equal symmetry line, right? This is very, very, very important. Okay, so we know that symmetry line is also bisector line. Therefore, AD line is a bisector line and symmetry line. Symmetry line. Okay, so here this angle is also alpha. That means 2 alpha equal 60 degrees. So alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.